Hey guys, I'm Chani and you're watching The Art of Science. So if you're a subscriber, welcome back. If not, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Let me fill this balloon up really quick. This is for the experiment, I promise. And now I'm gonna let it go. Oh wow, that flew upwards very quickly. Well, what you just saw is an example of Newton's third law. Today, we are going to look at Newton's third law of motion. The third law is the easiest one, and it states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. This means that when two objects interact, they both exert a force on each other, which is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Forces always come in pairs. There's the action force and the reaction force. Let's see it with an example. This is a huge encyclopedia and here's a smiley ball. When I push the ball against the book, we observe that the ball does not stop on hitting the book, but instead it bounces back and travels in the opposite direction. When the ball hits the book, it exerts a force on it, and this force is the action force, and it is in the direction of the book. However, the book also exerts the same amount of force on the ball, but in the opposite direction, which is in the direction of the ball. This force is known as the reaction force. Both these forces are equal in magnitude, but are opposite in direction. And that's the reason why the ball bounces and moves in the opposite direction. Suppose I punch the table. My fist exerts a force on the table, and in reaction, the table exerts an equal amount of force on my hand. And this is why when I punch the table with a higher force, the table also exerts a high force and I end up getting hurt. If you want to understand the third law with a cool experiment, please don't punch tables like I did. Instead, you can make this dry ice bottle rocket which uses the same principle. I have linked the video up here and in the description box as well. In fact, all rockets use Newton's third law of motion. A rocket produces gases which flow out of the back of the engine with a high force in the downward direction. This is the action force. In reaction, a thrusting force is produced in the upward direction that helps the rocket to fly. This is similar to what happened to my balloon in the beginning of the video. The air from the balloon escapes in the downward direction, and in turn, the air pushes the balloon in the upward direction. This is a balloon monorail which uses the same principle. It's a fun and interesting game that you can make at home. I have linked the video up here and in the description box as well. Newton's third law also applies when we are walking. When we walk, we push the ground backwards in action, and in reaction, with the same amount of force, the ground pushes us forward. Interesting, right? If you have any more doubts, let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you next week.